Now I'd like to show you a new technique that I've developed with the melting pot. The melting pot's great with ultra thick enamelling and it gives you fabulous effects using your rubber stamps. Again, I do like to use unmounted rubber stamps with this. They're more flexible, easier to work with, particularly when we're doing this technique. So I've got this beautiful poppy design. I've got my melting pot. I've switched the melting pot on to the higher setting for it to warm up. I'm just going to take it down a touch. If it's on too high, sometimes it can bubble the embossing powder. Left the lid on to get it nice and hot, but I'm just going to take that off now and show you what I've done inside the melting pot. I've created a little mat that just sits inside here. The way I've done this is with a spare craft sheet. I've got my craft sheet here underneath. And I've simply popped it down, drawn around the edge of it with a pen and cut it smaller. Then it can sit inside there and I can lift it out at any time. So once you've done that, you just reuse it time and time again. And for this particular technique, I'm going to use the white pearl ultra thick enamel. Now, another thing that you need to do is simply to wedge the melting pot up. So I'm going to take an ink pad. I'm going to pop it just under the back of here and this levels out the melting pot for me. Now you have to be very careful not to touch the metal. If you want to move the melting pot, you move it by the sides. It's extremely hot. I've leveled it out now. This stops the powder from actually flowing back in the melting pot because it's tilted down. So by supporting it at the back with an acrylic block or an ink pad, it will stop that tilt. Now I'm going to just sprinkle this into here. A nice, thin, even layer of powder onto the base, not going up to the edges. I don't want to do that. I just want to give myself a nice, even base. And then we're going to leave that to melt down and become molten. Now, the powders, it is important, really, that you use ultra-thick enameling. You could use your own embossing powders, but you need to have a thick, clear base of ultra-thick enamel, and then you can sprinkle those on. Some powders are great, some powders go a little bit muddy looking, so it's trial and error with them. Now, while that's melting down nicely for me, it will melt quicker if we actually put the lid back on and leave that to cure, to melt down. I'm going to take my stamp, pop it down on the table, and I'm going to use the Ranger Archival ink pad here in black. This is a really nice black ink. It's fade resistant, waterproof, non-smear, acid free, so you can use it for scrapbooking, and is really nice deep black. Now then, you can see that it's almost melted down in here. If I just take my tweezers and press down the area that hasn't quite melted, and that will put it in contact with the pan underneath and will melt it faster for us. Now you can see the bubbles starting to form. If I leave it too long, I will get a lot of bubbles and I don't want to do that. So now that's ready, I'm going to whip it out using the tweezers and very quickly take my poppy design, bending this in the middle, dropping it into it and tapping it into the molten powder. Be careful not to touch the powder around the edge because it will burn you while it's hot. Now that just needs to be left for a little while to cure and to set, and then doesn't take long. You can see we can lift this now, we can move it around. And this is why I like to use the unmounted stamps, because now I can peel that off and I have my beautifully cut poppy design into this molten powder. And then using my little craft sheet at the back of it, I can peel this away and have that fabulous piece of artwork ready for me to pop onto my card. Now, I like the way this creates this filigree edging too. It just finishes it off beautifully. What we can do now to add some detail onto that is just to take the quickie glue pen. I'm just going to squiggle over some of this on the inside. Doesn't have to be perfect by any means, but we want to have a nice sparkle added to it. I'm going to take some glitter, sprinkle this all over, tap the excess off, There you go. And once that glue dries, where it's blue will become clear. We have that beautiful sparkly poppy. I think it's very elegant with the white pearl with the black ink. Pop the glitter back in the pot to reuse. We don't want to waste it. There we go. And then matting this onto our card, what I use is silicone glue. Nice thin layer across the back of here. Stick that down into the card. It will keep it nice and flat for you. Now, the card that I've created, and this is the finished card, this is using Basil cardstock. It's using the Basil Bling in this beautiful creamy colour for the background. I've cut the card down from a nice large sheet of 12 inch by 12 inch. And then I've also used cardstock with an edge from Basil too. And it's these little sets that are so beautiful, all different shapes of cardstock. And this is the actual one that I've used to decorate the front of my card, as you can see there. And quite simply, just in a quick step-by-step format for you, we've cut the Basil card down to form an A5 size. Then we've taken this little section and quite simply, you lay it over the front of the card, see where you want it to be, flip it over to the back, draw around the back edge, and then you cut that off and you have your section. Stuck it directly onto the card front, our poppy design with silicone glue onto the front of that, some adhesive stones in between all the little scallops, and then we've added some black ribbon down the side, just sticking that down with a tape runner, a double-sided tape, and then a little bow onto the front. Crafty individuals do some beautiful stamps that work particularly well with the melting pot. These are the beautiful fairies, one of my personal favourites. And you can see here we've combined them with the Duo Reflections card and gorgeous colours of the UT, platinum on this one, gold over here, using the black archival ink pad again, just to stamp into them and attaching the black ribbon, which I think pulls it all together. I've also used these fabulous moulding mats, which are long pieces of rubber that have designs created in them, created for use actually with a different technique, but I think they are perfect for me to use with the ultra thick enameling, as you can see on both of these cards. You can use them as a stamp, you can use them to sink into the molten powder. On this one, for something a little bit different, we've also used this Basil Basics tool, and this we've popped into the melting pot and poured the powders on top of it, just as I showed you, and then stamped into it. But it creates this metally effect and gives you this bubbles and texture in there too. So experiment with some tool and different mediums. And just a few more samples here to show you different ideas using the melting pot. This is using the purple and pink embossing powder. This one with the dark green, the poppy design that we used earlier. Again, giving them more of a transparent look using the clear embossing enamel underneath those particular two. And then finally, we've used the pink embossing powder, the UT, and we've put the champagne Encore Ultimate Metallic over the top of it. Again, I think the black really lifts these colours directly to make them jump out off the card.